WABSNAZSM presents Notes from My Mom.
Right, where do I begin? I'll start at the very end. My mum died in 2022, at Christmas time, which was her absolute favourite part of the year. She'd really been through it for the previous couple of years, and I can only guess that she just had had enough of it all and departed with a whisper. Her rich history of adventure took some surprising twists and turns, which I can only view from the vantage point of historical wonderment. From running away to France as a teenager to wandering along the Great Wall of China, from having her boots destroyed by the bomb squad to demolishing a small wall at Asda during a driving lesson, she'd seen a lot of life and this bewildering world. Her family meant the most to her, though. The world was at home, and she was at home in her world. When I was a kid, I found a number of her cherished 7-inch singles from her younger days. The titles of the songs and the names of the artists really meant very little to me. I was ignorant as to the true meaning of music as a rite of passage. I treated the records pretty badly as I played them at various speeds, backwards, forwards, skidding the stylus across the vinyl. As I said, I was very disrespectful. Well, here's where the apology begins, because I've dredged through my memories of the collection, and of course, remembering that this was several decades ago, and I'll try to present the records as they should have been played by way of contrition. Some of them are quite good, and confusing too. Let's crack on with a tune that sounded very entertaining played at 78 RPM. Duane Eddy's Because They're Young. I actually quite enjoy this one now that I'm mature enough not to speed records up. It's a good twangy tune and deserves to be here. She once confided in me that she'd gone right off some of the music that she'd enjoyed in her youth. I think that was one of them, but I can't be sure about that anymore. She was a big fan of the Beatles and early rock and roll, but as she once said, I've heard them over and over again. How many times can you listen to Ticket to Ride without going nuts? I get it. There are tunes that I'd rather go deaf before hearing again, but that's not what this is all about. Strangely, despite giving the Beatles a swerve, she remained interested in Paul McCartney, or at least this epic explosion of pomp and swagger. Live and Let Die was one record that I enjoyed, but mainly for the daft B-side. I won't play that now because it's not quite as good. I'll move out of the way now for Fab Macca.
When you were young and your heart was an open book, you used to say, ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry. let die.
She certainly had a thing for the twang back in the mists of time, which I reckon showed a stylish and true understanding of good music. Again, this is a record that got more than its fair share of abuse from me. I liked playing with sound, and although I fell far short of inventing hip-hop, I sure could scratch a record. I'm looking for a cool nickname, but can only come up with DJ Mozchops. It'll have to do. Anyway, this is Oh Pretty Woman by Roy Orbison. He used to give me the creeps. Funny hair, funny glasses, and he'd go rrrr on his songs.
Pretty woman, walking down the street. Pretty woman, the kind I like to meet. Pretty woman, don't walk on.
Never quite get over the fact that my mum said that he looked like Benny Hill's racist Chinese man character. He actually did. Unintentional but unforgettable. How can I take him seriously again? As I said previously, there were a few surprises in this collection. This was another one that I played at 78 quite a lot. I wonder whether my mum could hear her precious records getting a beating on the turntable upstairs. She never said anything about it, but then she was too busy keeping a home running with so many demanding people and a super smart dog all wanting something. Food, clean socks and arbitration during another daft conflict. So here we have Brennan on the Moor, a song about an Irish highwayman. It doesn't end too well for him, but they got a song out of it, so that's something, I suppose. Brennan on the Moor.
There was a brave young highman, and the story we will tell. His name was Willie Brennan, and in Ireland he did dwell. 'Twas on the Gilbert Mountains he commenced his wild career, and everyone looked them over, and before him shook with fear. Did young Brennan on the Moor, Brennan on the Moor, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the Moor. One day all on the highway, as Willie he went down, he met the mayor of Cashel, a mile outside of town. The mayor, he knew his features, and he said, young man, says he, your name be Willie Brennan, you must come along with me. Did young Brennan on the Moor, Brennan on the Moor, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the Moor. Now Willie's wife had gone to town some victuals for to buy, and when she saw her Willie, she commenced to weave and cry. Saint Anthony, as soon as Willie spoke, she handed him a blunderbuss from underneath her coat. To young Brennan on the Moor, Brennan on the Moor, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the Moor. Now with this load of blunderbuss, the truth I will unfold. He made the mayor to tremble, and he robbed him of his gold. £100 was offered for his apprehension there, and he with horse and saddle to the mountains did repair. Did young Brennan on the Moor, Brennan on the Moor, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the Moor, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the Moor.
That was all right. It's the first time that I've heard it at the correct speed in a very long time. I shudder to think how I used to treat vinyl. What a complete chump. I wouldn't do it now. It's a bit late for that though. Another interesting item now. I listened to this one quite a lot when I was a kid. I think that my mum would have approved of a record that might put me into a state of trance for half an hour. It was on an EP with several other famous tracks from the same source, but this one was the winner for me. It still is a funny little piece of magic, and I'm happy to reconnect with it now after all of the long decades away from its spiralling curls.
Trust in me, just in me. Shut your eyes. Trust in me. Hold still, please. You can sleep safe and sound, knowing I am around. Slip into silent slumber. Sail on a silver slowly and surely your senses will cease to resist. Trust in me and just in me. Shut your eyes and trust.
Honestly, don't know where some of these records appeared from. Obviously, there are some great choices, such as some of the tunes that I've already played, but this next one is not quite what you might have expected. I actually asked my mum about this one. Where did you get it? Well, she told me that she'd saved up some tokens from packets of rice and sent off for it. I doubted it then, and nothing has changed. The Moon Hop by Derek Morgan was written to commemorate the moon landing in 1969. And was fascinating to me. I'd never heard music like it. The squealing and, to me, incomprehensible lyrics. It seemed a little scary, but I enjoyed listening and watching the yellow and red label revolving. I'm tempted to play the A and the B side, as they both appeal to the younger version of me. I'll make a decision on that in a minute. Actually, no. I'm going to play them now. See you in a few minutes, Rice fans.
We'll be right back.
On the crab label, the moon hop followed by Harris Wheel. Your guess is as good as mine. Pretty entertaining though. Another song that I remember hearing a lot back in the ancient days can still send me careening back through the decades to a time when everything was easy. It was played a great deal at my nan and granddad's flat, but I've been thinking about this and I'm pretty sure that it belonged to my mum on a single. It seemed to be a real favourite, or possibly it was the only other record at my grandparents' place. It was this or Captain Ginger by John Inman. I'm not going to play that as it's bloody awful, but I will present now, for your delight, Yes to Me, Yes to You, Yesterday by Stevie Wonder. All of these records had a crunchy crackle to them. They were not very well looked after, and as I've said, I made things a great deal worse. I scratched them, I used them as short-range frisbees, and I tried to play them with sewing needles. There ought to have been a restraining order out against me with regard to records. I cannot believe that I did such things. Actually, I can. I was a little git, and I'm sorry about that. I'm a bigger git now, though. We're going to get into top-notch yodeling territory next. Frank Ifield was someone who never failed to make me laugh. Clearly, I missed out on the heartbreaking subtleties involved in the lyrics and I just went for the comedy. I'd pop this on the turntable and spin the record with one finger, or really whip it so it played at 110 RPM. He sounded like a man calling for help on a deflating airbed. Let's put this right by actually playing I Remember You by Frank Ifield, shall we? Without doing anything stupid with it.
I remember you. You're the one who made my dreams come true a few kisses ago. I remember you. You're the one who said I love you too. Yes, I do, didn't you know? I remember too a distant bell and stars that fell like the rain out of the blue. When my life is through and the angels ask me to recall the thrill of it all, then I will tell them I remember you. I remember too a distant bell and stars that fell just like the rain out of the blue. When my life is through and the angels ask me to recall the thrill of it all, then I will tell them I remember, tell them I remember, tell them I remember you.
Not as much yodeling as I remembered in that. It shows how much I mucked about with the records in the past. According to my mum, the 60s stopped swinging pretty quickly once she'd started a family. There's no time for Sergeant Pepper when you have an eye on mischievous babies with nursery crimes on their minds. Musical moods went fairly smooth, and over time, as the family expanded, other more dreamy music entered the arena. The Carpenters were bump-free without a rebellious note in their catalogue. We heard this rather a lot. I wonder what she was reaching for with this music. Hope? Another chance of happiness, or maybe she believed that she was in her best place. I can't get the answers to the questions that I often ask. She'd probably just say that it was nice, soothing, and mind your own business.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. Clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I've seen.
I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves on the trees and the touch of the breeze, there's a pleasing sense of happiness for me. There is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here.
I'm on the top of the world again, down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. You've been around. Your love's put me at the top of.
I've got to tell you that this has been one of the most difficult podcasts that I've ever had to put together. That's for obvious reasons, but does that make it any easier? Of course not. I'm shaking a fist at the sun and trying to make sense of it all. I mean, what the fuck? One day I'll fully grasp the enormity of it all, but right now I'm throwing rocks at the stars and trying to dislodge the power that takes us away. The very last time that I saw her, she didn't really know me. She described me as her friend, and I like to think that's how it always was, a friend. She sang for me that day, and it took every ounce of her strength to do so. At the end of the song, she gave me the thumbs up, which was very much like her. She tried. She gave it her very best. It was marvellous. Finally, on the day that she was lauded and applauded, the song that she truly left us with was played over the speakers of the chapel. She always liked this one, and with her departure, we were diminished. But the song goes on.
Please to be with you. Look around, see what you do.